transcribed into English as Lal Killa, is a 17th century fort complex constructed by the Mughal Emperor Shah Jahan in the walled city of Old Delhi that served as the residence of the Mughal emperors. The fort was the palace for Mughal Emperor Shah Jahan's new capital, Shahjahanabad, the seventh city in the Delhi site. He moved his capital here from Agra in a move designed to bring prestige to his reign and to provide ample opportunity to apply his ambitious building schemes and interests. It served as the capital of the Mughals until 1857, when Mughal Emperor Bahadur Shah Zafar was exiled by the British Indian government. Lies along the Yamuna River, which fed the moats that surround most of the walls. The wall at its northeastern corner is an adjacent to an older fort, the Salimgarh Fort, a defense built by Islam Shah Suri in 1546. The construction of the Red Fort began in 1638 and was completed by 1648. The Red Fort has had many developments added on after its construction by Emperor Shah Jahan. The significant phases of development were under Aurangzeb and later under Mughal rulers. It was designated a UNESCO World Heritage Site in 2007. The Red Fort derives its name from the extensive use of red sandstone on the massive walls that surround the fort. Shah Jahan commissioned the construction of the Red Fort in 1638 when he decided to shift his capital from Agra to Delhi. Ustad Ahmad and Ustad Hamid were chosen as the architects for construction of the royal palace. Construction began in the auspicious month of Muharram on 13th May 1638. Construction of the fort was supervised by Shah Jahan himself and was completed in 1648. The Red Fort was originally referred to as Killa-e-Mubarak, that is, the Blessed Fort, because it was the residence of the royal family. Unlike the other Mughal forts, layout of the boundary walls of the Red Fort is not symmetrical so as to retain and integrate the older Salimgarh Fort. The walls of Lahore and Delhi gates were for the general public and Khizrabad gate was for emperor's personal use. The Lahore gate is the main entrance. It leads to the domed arcade containing shops called the Chhata Chowk, that is, covered bazaar. Silk, jewelry and other items which catered to the royal household were sold in Chhata Chowk, that is, in the covered market in Mughal period. Chhata Chowk leads to a large open space where it crosses the large north-south street that was originally the division between the fort's military functions to its west and the palaces to its east. The southern end of this street is the Delhi Gate. Every year on 15th August, the day India achieved independence from the British, Prime Minister of India hoists the national flag at the Red Fort, followed by a nationally broadcast speech from its ramparts. The Red Fort is one of the most popular tourist destinations in Old Delhi, attracting thousands of visitors every year. Also happens to be the largest monument in Old Delhi. Lahore Gate leads to a retail mall with jewelry and craft stores. There is a museum of blood paintings depicting young Indian martyrs of the 20th century along with the story of their martyrdom. There is also an archaeological museum and an Indian War Memorial Museum. Mughals brought with them the Western Asian tradition of developing gardens to symbolically represent paradise on earth. Planning and design of the Hayat Baksh Bagh or life bestowing garden was integrated into the design of the Red Fort. The garden comprised many aesthetically designed structures such as tanks, pavilions, water channels and fountains which complemented flowers of varying colors and trees of various kinds. The Red Fort covers a total area of about 254 acres enclosed with 2.4 kilometers of defense walls. The walls are punctuated by turrets and bastions. They vary in height from 18 meters on the river side to 33 meters on the city side. The fort is shaped like an octagon with the north-south axis longer than the east-west axis. Fortress Palace was an important focal point of the medieval city of Shahjahanabad, present-day Old Delhi. The planning and aesthetics of the Red Fort represent the zenith of Mughal creativity which prevailed during the reign of Emperor Shah Jahan. Aurangzeb, Shah Jahan's successor, added the Moti Masjid to the Emperor's private quarters and constructed barbicans and front of the two main gates, which made the entrance route to the palace more beautiful. Use of marble, floral decorations, double domes in the buildings inside the fort exemplifies the later phase of Mughal architecture. It showcases a very high level of art form and ornamental work. It is believed that the Kohinoor diamond was part of the furniture. The artwork in the fort is a synthesis of Persian, European and Indian art, which resulted in the development of a unique Shahjahani style which is very rich in form, expression and color. The southernmost pavilions of the palace are zananas or women's quarters, the Mumtaz Mahal, now a museum, and the larger lavish Rang Mahal, which has been famous for its gilded, decorated ceiling and marble pool fed by Nahr-i-Behisht. Thank you. Red Fort is one of the important building complexes of India, which encapsulates a long period of Indian history and its arts. Even before its notification as a monument of national importance in the year 1913, efforts were made to preserve and conserve the Red Fort for posterity. Diwani Am, or the Hall of Public Audiences, the Emperor, seated in a canopied alcove, would hear complaints and pleas of the commoners through a jarokha, that is, balcony. The hall was ornamented with stucco work and featured a series of gold columns. It also included a large railing that separated the commoners from the Emperor. The Diwani Am was also used for state functions. The spacious Mardana or courtyard behind the Diwani Am is surrounded by several interesting structures, though the function and purpose of some of them remain an enigma. If you happen to be in Delhi, a visit to Red Fort is a must.